Yes, hello guys, and welcome back to my YouTube channel. And it's been long since we... It's not been long, I'm kidding. So it's the other day, I think. So today, we want to learn about Java constructors. Remember in the previous video, we talked about Java methods. We learned on how to create methods in a class, and also call a method using an object, and also using the static here. So leave aside that. So today we want to talk about this constructor. So what's a constructor? You know, a constructor in Java is a special method that is used to initialize objects. The constructor is called when an object of a class is created. So it can be used to set initial values for object attributes. For example, let's do this thing practically so that you guys can understand what I'm saying. So I'm going to create a class here. Let me create a class, and I'm going to create Java application and next. So this one, I just want to call it constructor. So remember, we start with caps. Oh, what's happened? Okay, refresh. New project, and then Java application, and here we go. So I write constructors, and constructor. Well, then you finish that. So guys, you know, I think we're getting into a deeper thing, if I may say so. You know, wherever we have, what we have been doing, it's a bit of different, you know. Let's say, let's talk about Java methods, and also talk of what? Java tutorial, those are different things. And also, now, this is a major topic, you know. The first topic we talked about was Java tutorials, and also we learned Java methods, but now this one is actually Java classes, which is the Java object-oriented programming. So in this category is kind of deep. It's deeper than the other things that we've been doing. So guys, I think this is the part where coding is winning. This is the part where coding has been, I mean, coding is getting into its own way, right? So I've created a class, and so I just want to do one more example here so that I can show you what is this constructor is about. Well, let me zoom this so that you can see it clearly. There we go. So I'm going to create this class. I've created a class. Let's do this example here so that we can understand what we are doing. So what am I going to do? Okay, I've created a class. Let me create some variable here. So I'm going to create an integer variable. And then that is it. So I name it X. Then in this class, I want to create a constructor. How am I going to do that? It's simple. You know, here what you want to do is come down and then scroll down a little bit, and then what you have to remember when you're creating a constructor. Let me just write it first, and I just write public. Public class, and then public, then I take the class name, that is constructor, this one here. That's how you put constructor. You just take the class name, then remember not to include the class here, but just take the class name, then you paste it there if you're not lazy, you know what I mean. So from here, next what we're going to do is going to put this Calling, then carry traces, and it's keep a little bit down here. There we go, right? So this I've created a constructor for the class constructor. I wish I could have named this another name so that you cannot confuse you any. I'm sure you're not getting confused. So here, the next thing I'm going to do, I'm just going to create another variable here. No, not really creating a variable, but this can be bad. And then I just want to move this a little bit. I'm going to do that. Just going to space. Well, so we have created a constructor. We just put the class name and then we just declare the public so that it can be seen from other classes. So that is it. The next thing I'm going to do, I just want to create a. I just want to assign this x a number. So I'm just going to type x is equal to let's say 7, right? A very simple number here. Then we just scroll down to the main method here. What we need to do here, I want to create an object. You know, when you just want to call a method, you need to create an object, and especially the method, you know, if there is no static, you know, if there is no static keyword, then you need to create an object. Definitely, this is mind of the previous video that we did. So here I'm just going to create an object of constructor, right? So I'm going to take the class name, that is the constructor there, and then create an object is equal to, then with a new keyword, then just the same name here. So I have created an object. So I just want to print the value of x. Definitely I just want to take an object, obj.x, but this one is going to actually to confuse you guys. Let me just do that. Let s out. Say s out. Then tab. S out, then, what happened? Okay, I just want to system dot out dot print line. What is it? So here I'm going to call the, here I'm going to print the value of x. So I'm just going to take this obj. Remember using the dot to call the exact value. So here I'm just going to hit enter. That is it. So here I've just assigned x with 7. Here I just want to call the here I just want to print something in the console. So if I run this project, let me run it, and it says, and see what you have on the concept there. We have 7. So in simple term, this is in other ways, we have created a constructor. A constructor, you have just see that you just take the class name, and then you declare with the public keyword, and then that is it. So the next thing you have to do is just to call the you call that method using an object. So the note here is that the constructor name must match the class name. You know, it must match the class name, and it cannot have a run type. It cannot have the return type the void. So also know that the constructor is called when object is created. So once you create an object, you have called the constructor. So another thing you have to know is that all classes have constructors by default. You know, you see here we are created, but by default all classes have the constructor. if you do not create a class constructor yourself, Java normally it actually creates one for you if you didn't create. Now you see you have created, but if you never created it, then Java actually creates for you. However, then you are not. However, what I have to say is that you may not be able to set initial values for the object attributes. So that is it, guys. And then the second thing we want to see is on how to do what, guys? To pass in the parameters in the constructor. So in this subtopic, we want to learn about constructor parameters. So what is this? Constructor can also, what you have to remember is that constructor can also take parameters as like other methods. But this one is a special method, if I may call that so. And the other thing is that these parameters are used to initialize attributes. For this example that I'm going to do, I'm going to add an int, let's say an int x parameter to a constructor. Inside the constructor, I'm going to set x to, let's say, yes, x to y, so that we can have the, signing the value with the same value. So when we call the constructor, we pass a parameter to the constructor. So that's what we want to do, which will set the value of x to a number, let's say 4. For example, let me do this example here. It's simple. So just come down, and then I've created this class, right? I have this class above here. Then I just assign. So guys, here I just want to change a bit of things here so that you don't have to write everything. So here I'm just going to change this to y, and then from there we have an object down here, right? Then the next thing we should do is we need to pass this when we are calling this constructor over here, we need to pass an int type so that we can call this constructor. So I'm going to just declare an int, then let me say y, right? So what I've done here is so simple. I'm going to pass in, I'm going to pass a number, that is it. So I've passed this 5 here, just passed this 5 here, and then from there it's going to assign x. Now x will be 5. That is it. So let's print out and see what we have. So guys, as you can see on the console, we have 5. So that is simple. I have to remind you what I said before. I just said that we added an int y parameter to the constructor. This one here. To the constructor. Inside the constructor, we set x. We set x y here. You can see here. We just set x is equal to y. When we call the constructor, this constructor above here, we pass a parameter to the constructor. As you can see, we have a constructor down here. We pass the number, which is 5. Then, which will set the value of x to 5. That is it. So, guys, we have seen what is parameters in a constructor. Another example, one more example, so that we can conclude. So we can also have many parameters as you want. So I just want to do them here. Let me do them here so that you can see how we can have several parameters. So I just want to create another class. Allow me to create another class, new project, and then new Java. Then next year I'm going to create, car. I'm going to call a class a car. Let's call it car. Car. It seems that I have already put. Okay, let me just add R. So the R don't even. This one. Let me change this to, let's see, something here like that. So I finish here. Well, so let me generalize so you can see it clearly. So here, guys, I just want to create another constructor. Yeah, let me do a little things here. So in this car, I just want to create a variable. The first one is an int type. Let's call model. Let's say model of the car. Model year. Let me add y. So the next one, I just want to create a string type variable. So here I'm just going to create string model. Model, maybe model name, right? So that is it. So let me create a constructor below this. So I just want to come a little bit, just scroll down a little bit, then create a constructor. So guys, by now I know how to create a constructor. Just click a public bucket, then you take the class name, that is car t, that is the class name, then that is it. So here you just you want to pass parameters inside here. So I just want to pass an int type parameter, that is the year that that model was done. And then the second parameter I just want to pass is the string type. String the name, right? The model name. That is it. So then here this where is it? I'm bringing this. Okay, string. Oh, okay, just everything. String. And then next, what I'm going to do is just to space here. And then I just have to send this. So down here I just want to keep the model here, back here, with this thing type. I'm going to copy this because I'm really lazy when it comes to typing. So there, and then I just want to paste here, then assign it is equal to the year. So that it can merge, and just it can align with the one the parameters that are assigned inside the packet. Then the second one is actually the model name. You should copy that, then paste down here. So it's equal to the name, right? The name. That is it. So the next thing I'm going to do, I'm going to create, you know definitely what I'm going to do, you know that. I'm going to create an object. So I'm just going to pick this, as you know, when you create an object, you have to pick this so that you can get it better. Now when you're creating an object, you must pick the class name. So Control V, then just delete that. Then whatever OBJ is equal to, OBJ you can create any name you want. So this is my way to show you for learning purposes. I have to show you this an object. So then from here, keyword new, then press that. Next thing we're going to do, we're going now to create we want to pass this parameter, the values. So I'm going to pass them here, and let me say 1990 or 19 over 2000, right? The year that model was done. And then the next thing that I'm going to do is to assign to give the name of the car. So I'm going to say whatever, Range Rover, right? Then here I've created an object, and also I've passed in some parameters, variables. So the next thing that I'm going to do, I just want to print out and then we'll see what we have. So Okay. System dot out. Oh. Okay. System dot out at print file. Print file. That is it. So what I'm going to do here, I just want to print something on the console, so nice, something that makes sense. Let me say my car. Oh, okay. I'm just going to pick these this word. I want you to pick this obj dot model. As you can see, it's actually predicted what you want to do. It's automatic. So obj model. Okay, this one I did is let me just let me put it in order. So model dot maybe here, the make of the year map that was made. Okay. And then we concatenate with, let's space it a little bit. Then the other one, that is my car model name. So I'm going to pick the same obj dot. This is now the model what? The model name. So that is it. So the next thing that I'm going to do is to make sure that the error is not there. It's mean, okay, yeah, I missed a plus here. That is it. So let me run this and see what we have on the console. As you can see, we have 2000 Range Rover. Let me space this at least a little bit. Let me run it again. So we have the year we have 2000. Then the name of the car is the Range Rover. So guys, as you can see, that is a multiple. I can call this is a multiple. How do you say it? This is passing actually many parameters in this constructor. So we're trying to pass several parameters in a constructor. So here, you have to explain a little bit before I finish this video. We created a constructor, and a constructor here, you just pick the class name, and remember not to include the void because then you've done something. So just declare the public car, and then you pass in the parameters. So those parameters is the variable that you created above. You want to pass. It's like passing. You want to pass the parameter to these variables. So once you call this constructor, you're just going to create an object and then assign it. I mean, passing the variables. Then once it's called the constructor, it's assigned, and then that is it. So guys, I can say by now you understand what a constructor is. And this is the end of the video. Thank you so much, guys. I hope that you have gotten something. You at least I know you have gotten something. So guys, goodbye, and don't forget to subscribe my channel if you find this useful. Thank you.